Hello and welcome to Florence Classical Arts Academy. Today we're going to talk about lips and about construction of the lips. But right now we don't have all our students with us, which is we're going to take a few minutes and wait them. And I hope you will enjoy our online information about online classes.
So we're happy to announce that this fall 2020, we will be launching our first online course for people who would love to start their professional education in visual arts and cannot yet come to Florence. So you can start just where you are at home. So now let's go together to our studio and you can learn more about the options that you have while taking your online education with us. You will have three options to choose from. You will have the first option that provides for you all the information, all the modules that contain videos, that contain all the written files, all the comments and images. So essentially everything that you need to study on your own, in your own pace. Second option provides for you also full range of information that contains videos, written files, all the comments, all the images. Plus, weekly, you will be followed by your professor through online group chat. You will also get to interact with your virtual classmates, which means that you will be learning not only from the professor, but also by interacting with your classmates. And you will see your own progress in time and other people's progress as well. Second option as well includes a one-month course in Florence in the end of your program. Third option is the fullest one, and it provides you with all the information you need, so the same set, all the videos, all the written files, comments, everything that you need to have in order to study at home. Plus, weekly, you will be followed by your professor through an individual online conference where they will follow your progress step by step and will give you all the individual attention that you need. If you choose also a third option, in the end of your program, you get 2 full months of the course here physically with us in Florence. Both second and third option provide for you a professional certificate in the end of the program. And with this certificate, you're eligible to apply for the second year of the 3-year program and continue your professional education here with us in Florence. But the enrollment is already open, so if you're interested, don't be shy. You can contact us already and you can let us know that you're interested, and we will be sure to provide all the information and give you all the details. And hopefully, once you're done with this course, you can join us in Florence and come to this magical city and continue your professional education with us.
Hello again, which is, as I mentioned, today we will start talk about lips. And lips, it's a very interesting part of our face, and it's really giving feelings about person when you look at the lips. And very often when students drawing the lips, they're making a mistake. Why? Because very often people draw outline of the lips, not understanding construction inside it. And to understand construction inside the lips, it's what we're going to draw today with different position and different schemes, which is giving us understanding about whole plane and about how form of the lips developing. But before we're going to do it, I would like to show you lips of the David, and I would like to show you profile position. And for you, it's very important to understand before you're going to draw at any position lips, to look at this plane. And here in profile position, you need to understand actually character of the lips. And this is characteristic of the lips you could understand if you will put, like I'm doing now, something straight. Pencil or a pen, anything. And this is character, understanding what lip actually come out and which lip will be a little bit more inside. This is giving us understanding when we will putting this straight line. If we're talking about the lip, of course, we need to understand plus anatomy. And what kind actually lip? Lips which has come out on us, or lips which is inside, lips thin or lips thick. That all depending on our jaw, and of course depending on our teeth. And those kind position of our teeth is actually giving us understanding of what kind form we will have in our lips. And now we're going to draw with you those schemes. And before we will start it, we will just will in profile position try to put all different lips what you could see around you. Let's start. I'm using a soft pencil, and you could do it together with me. I really suggest you not just watch right now what I'm doing, but try to repeat together with me what I'm doing. And here we will start it, as I already mentioned, to draw different type of the lip. Example, let's draw this type of the lip. And as you see, if I will put something straight, this plane will become out a little bit more, and this will become out a little bit less. Let's see different type of the lip. Again, this lip will become out a little bit more, this lip will become out a little bit less, but if we're looking at previous one, characteristic of that plane respect of that lip will be different. Here it will be thinner and here it will be lower. Let's look at this type of the lip. And here we have totally different situation, which is this lip, this plane, come out on us much more, and that one remain here. Let's look at this type of the lip. If I will put the plane, they're totally attached. Very important information. Your jaw and your teeth considering a good shape if this part of the lip a little bit come out on that one. If it's not happening, this plane, it means you have a little bit difficulty with teeth or maybe it's not a correct shape. Let's look at those type of the lip. And this one, very typical for very thin lip. Again, if we will put it plain, it will be closer to each other. And we'll see those kind of in this case, distance between that and that lip will be really big, which is difference between this plane and this plane will be really a lot, which is all those type of the lip and much more you could find in nature. And to understand how to deal with that and what kind of lips you have in front of you, of course, you will need to look at the model. Model will give you understanding what kind of character you need to draw, and depends on that model, you need to understand the proportion. But all of those different type of the lips have all same construction, which is what will be changing. Will be changing proportion of the lip, will be changing inclination, but construction inside will be remain same, which is all those lips will have planes, what we're going to draw now. But before we're going to do it, I would like to show you a position, a very simple, geometrical of the lip from, again, profile. we're going to draw with you those type of the lip. Very geometrical shape, but it's good to us because it's giving us understanding how lip will be simplified, all those difficult form, how it's going to be simplified and what kind of muscle we have in the lip, which is here, around. I will put round muscle and we'll put main point. Right now, let's see how developing those muscle around the lip, which is we will have this plane, we will have this plane, and we will have that plane. This is plane around the lip. It's actually helping, first of all, of course, it's open the lip. Second, it's giving shape of the lip. And we can't draw the lip without understanding whole plane around it. Let's draw position of the lip with a different example with three quarter position. We'll see what will be happening with lip with three quarter position. And before we're going to do it, let's try to understand from what we need to start. And to start to draw the lip in three quarter position, we need to start from understanding what lip is actually in the round shape, which is those kind round shape. It's where we're going to put our lip. This will be plane of the lip, and inside of that we're going to put it. Very typical mistake what we have, it's when person trying to draw the lip without understanding what it's in the round shape, trying to draw it straight. And when people draw it the straight direction, lip not giving feelings about, first of all, about perspective. And those type of understanding about perspective and how to put lip in three quarter position in the perspective, giving us understanding what lip is in the round shape, those type. And let's start, before we're going to build all shape, let's start to see what kind of stages we need to understand. Line, of course, central line of the lip. This is something what we need to show, central line of the lip. After, on those line, we need to put this round shape. This is, will be middle of the lip. Now we need to understand how the plane of the lip will be connected here, this one. And we need to find central line of the lip, which is those central line. In profile, it will be this one. In three quarter, we need find it. And we need to find those plane, we need to find those plane, and plane how it's attaching here with filter of the nose. Let's draw it, which is, let's figure out this plane. This plane will be reconnected here, goes inside, connected with shape of the end of the lip, corner of the lip. Center line never will be really straight, it will be have some movement. Very often, because we have those muscle, this plane, this here getting a little bit upper. Let's see now for this plane. This plane we could represent in all different construction. Some people represent it like this. Some people get it more information inside that plane. And those type of different information is what we're going to do with you now, which is, let's figure out again, we're going to do straight line. On the straight line in three quarter position, we're going to put round shape of the lip. It could be, depends on your perspective position. Inside, we're going to find center line, corner of the lip, understanding which part is go upper, this one or this one. And this is we could figure out to see from side of our lip. And let's put information here, which is this one, philtrum of the nose, end of the lip. Center line, I repeat myself, corner of the lip, end of the lip, philtrum of the nose. This is first things with what we started to figure out our lip in three quarter position. Right now, let's start to draw a position of the lip with fast position. And with fast position, we will have this kind of situation, which is our center line became a little bit with inclination. It's not going to be straight. This will be a little bit round. But this corner and center line will be exactly equal, which is those two parts, this one and this one, will be equal one. If it's in three-quarter position, we see this plane bigger respect of the center line here, and this plane will be smaller, again, respect of the center line. In a position of fuzz, we will have all those plane is equal, which is, let's put philtrum of the nose, let's figure out shape of the lip. Let's put central line a little bit more low. Figure out end of the lip. Again, I repeat myself what this planes, depending on human, what you're going to draw. Some of them could have smaller, some of them could have larger. This is all depends on model. We will just try now understand the planes in it. Here, we will have this kind of situation. What this plane normally a little bit come out from the center of the line, making those kind of cup here. This line going a little bit upper, and again going a little bit upper. That is normally what we could see in a very like standard situation with lip. Now that plane will have a little bit more thickness, and I am going to draw it here like those shape, and it's going to be a little bit like separated in two planes. Here it goes inside, here it's come out on us, which is those plane, a little bit come out on us, and that one goes inside. In the corner of the lip, here and here, normally we will get slightly more darker. And in position, if we have light goes from top, this plane will be get part of the shadow or middle of tone. Depends how close light you have to the model. Now let's see what's happening with a low lip. And low lip, let's draw some shape, we'll have this kind plane inside. Plane, which is come out on us here, and goes in. I could see here on upper lip two planes, and in this one much more complex, which is, as you see, one, two, three, four. Four different planes. And again, depends of what kind of light we have. We have all type of different shape of that, not shape, but tone of that lip, which is if we have light goes from this direction, this plane will get part of the shadow. This plane will be get a little bit tone too, but less respect to that one. And this one will get a little bit tone too. Very often, inside, under the lip, this part will get part of the shadow. Of course, it depends what kind source of the light you have, but in condition of source of the light goes from top, it always will be in the shadow. Now let's figure out what's happening with those muscle. And muscle here will getting rounder and goes with connection with filter of the nose. Same things will happening here. And here we will have same type of the shape, round one. Normally, those connection here with lip, we're going to make a little bit darker in the tone, and here a little bit darker under the lip. This plane, as it goes rounder, normally we're getting a little bit with some middle of tone. And some tone will be inside here. Let's figure out what's happening inside those shape. And this one come out on us. Goes as a small triangle connection with a part of here. Same happening with this distance. And we will get part of the chin. Again, some people have this plane bigger. Some people have this plane even attached by the lip. Some people have it much smaller. It all depends personality what you're drawing. Here we have, this is kind of situation. Normally it's going a little bit upper and changing direction here. Same happening here, goes upper. And we'll be changing here direction. Let's now figure out a little bit more tone inside here. Which is, if light coming from here, this part will get in the shadow. This plane a little bit come out on us, which is will get slightly part of the middle of tone. And this one again got shadow. This one will be darker, getting middle of tone, but not same dark as here. And that plane will get some tone too. Let's put now main points where is changing the form, which is it will be here, form changing here, form changing here. As we already mentioned, form will be changing here, here. This plane of the lip will be changing form, connection, the plane part which has come out on us. Again, connection of the plane. Where is plane finishing here? Of course, end of the lip. Now, plane here. Changing planes here. End of the chin. Connection here. This will be main points when form will be changing direction, when you will need to put maximum attention on. Now let's talk a little bit more about distribution of the tone. Where to put accent when you're drawing this the part of the lip? We need to put accent when its form is changing direction, which is here, our form come out, changing direction, we will put a little bit accent. There is separation between the lip, middle, we will get slightly darker. Normally, this top lip giving on the bottom lip a little bit cast shadow. It's why we have really strong dark color between. One more plane, what we will get a little bit light, it will be here, which is this one here and that one. Here. Connection of the lip and this and this plane when lip come out on us will be getting highlight. Depends again about source of the light, how close it to the lip. You could get it stronger or less stronger, but it will be always where is part of the lip come out on us. And inside of the corner of the lip here and here you will get much more stronger tone too. Now, here we will get part of the shadow normally getting a little bit accent. And here on the bone of the chin, when bone come out on us, some people have different shape. Here, some people have shape like that. Some people have it straighter. Fat people nearly don't have visible this shape because bones cover so much. But as you know anatomy, you always need to put a little bit accent on those parts to show what you're understanding, what inside its bone. Let's see now part of the lip from position of three quarter. From position three quarter, as we already mentioned, and we did a little bit draw here, we will now redraw it. We will have this situation. This is our top lip. This is our bottom lip. And let's put all those information what we already did inside here. As we already mentioned, we will have this structure. This one will be getting rounder. This one will be getting rounder here. But we'll have more planes in it. As we already mentioned here, it will be four planes. And now we're going to draw it here. This plane and this plane. In situation of three quarter, what we have? Respect of the center line, we will have this part bigger and this part smaller, which is all this part will be slightly bigger and all this part will be slightly smaller. With those knowledge, we will show what we're understanding perspective inside three-quarter position on the face. Let's put a rest of information in it. We're going to add this plane here when we're going to distribute our tone. a little bit more will emphasize part of the philtrum. Put inside here and here knowledge about round muscle. This plane will get a little bit part here, and this one will get a little bit part there. Let's add a tonal relationship. Again, if we have situation light coming from top and from the left, this plane will get shadow. Here will be slightly darker, and there will be a little bit more tone. Part of the middle between the lip became solid dark because cast shadow coming from this lip on that. This plane, this one here, will get a little bit more tone. And this one became slightly more darker. Let's add a little bit more tone in part where we will have shadow. Same happening here. This one will get a little bit more stronger, darker. But please not forget what this lip giving part of reflection on that one. It's why we can't get dark until end of the lip, because this lip getting reflection, if it's that lip will get cast shadow on that one, this one getting reflection to this one. Let's see now what's happening here. As we already mentioned, it will be darker. And we will have round muscle helping us to open our lip. Plane of the chin. And let's figure out where it's going to be center line first. If it's center line coming here, here we will get plane of our chin. In position of three quarter, it's not going to be straight, but a little bit moving towards the perspective, which is here and here, it will be a little bit more direction. And that part, as we mentioned here, will be changing here. Less we will see it from this side. This kind of situation we will have in three quarter position. Now let's look at position of profile of our lip, and that is very important. As we already mentioned, what profile giving us understanding what kind form and how to draw that form. Now let's look for profile position. First of all, as we already mentioned, we need to put straight line and understand, respect to the straight line, what's happening with our lip. Example, we will have this lip which is attaching straight line, and this lip which is a little bit come out. Let's see this kind of silhouette. Sometimes we see philtrum here, sometimes we don't, depends of how strong position is in the class, in the profile, sorry. Let's see how plane influence on the profile position. And we have this one, which is coming from here, attaching here form, which is goes inside and coming a little bit inside here. This plane will have here plane, will have this plane, will have this plane, this plane, and a little bit here, those. Let's figure out what's happening with center line. Normally, it's getting much darker here. This plane will getting a little bit tone. Come out in tone here, passing through the lip and coming here. We will put accent a little bit here. We will put accent a little bit here in the end of the form. And let's figure out what's happening with this plane. If we have light coming from this direction, this plane will get part of the light. This plane will get part of the light. But already here, it will be slightly more tone. This plane will get slightly more tone. This one will get part of the light. And very often here, we even get highlight. And that plane, opposite, it goes to the shadow. Very often here, we will get darker shadow. And this depends on situation, which is sometimes we're getting bigger this plane, sometimes it's smaller, but this is something what we need to figure out when we actually looking at the model. From here, we have, and from here, we will have this round muscle. This kind of situation, what you will getting here in this position. Now it's very important, as we did here, to put plane position where it's plane changing. Let's start from here. It will be changing here. We need to look where it's changing here. We need to figure out where it's end of the lip, where it's changing and connection with plane here, how it's come out on us here, changing plane here. One more plane will be here and there. This is about this position. Let's figure out what's happening 3/4. Again, with philtrum, we will have planes here. Plane attaching here, connection of plane here, and connection of plane there. Part which is come out on us, it's very important to understand, but of course planes, this one, two small plane here, which is normally getting a little bit lighter. We could distribute slightly more tone in the muscle. It's giving us more understanding what form is around. Now, plane here. Plane here. Connection with plane here and there. And again, we could distribute a little bit more tone. Changing direction plane here, getting slightly lighter. And here, getting a little bit more in tone. As we did already mention here. Okay, this is kind of information about scheme and about lips. It's really important because without knowledge about all those planes, you could just do silhouette of the lip without understanding how it's actually plane developing it. But with this practice of those schemes, it will giving you knowledge, and knowledge it's always could help you to make your drawing or painting more precisely. I hope you did learn something today, and I really wish for all of you repeat this as knowledge. I would like just one more time spend about very common mistake. Very common mistake, as I already mentioned, what people normally not putting round center line. One more common mistake, what people forgetting about perspective inside of the lip, and they're making both part and three-quarter position same proportion. One more mistake, it's what people not looking for central line here and what lip is actually coming or what is lip going down, which is those angle of the lip. It's very crucial and very important for us to understand character of our model. And of course, I wish for all of you repeat all those schemes many times as you can, which is you need to know the scheme by memory. And when you're drawing your model, you already will have it inside of your head, and you could draw with understanding of whole plane what it's necessary to show in our painting or drawing. And one more thing, I would like to wish for all of you happy Christmas and happy New Year.